I am Dr. Lakshmina, Consultant Neurosurgeon, Continental Hospital, Nanakramguda, Hyderabad. Generally, when this is, we diagnose this trigeminal neuralgia basically mainly from the clinical features, how the patient symptomatic, how the patient having pain. Depending on that, if it is a trigeminal neuralgia, we do kind of imaging like MRI, that is only to see whether it is a primary trigeminal neuralgia or secondary trigeminal neuralgia. If it is a secondary, then we have to deal with that particular type of cause, or if it is having any tumor, or it is having any other abnormality. If it is an idiopathic or primary, it is only vascular loop, we call in our terminology, vascular loop causing trigeminal neuralgia, then initially we go with medical treatment. We have certain kind of medications we give for some time, and mostly maybe around some 50 to 60% they get improve, or they have some good response with the medical treatment, that we have to continue. Otherwise we have other options like radio frequency ablation, and we have subarachnoid, and another one is microvascular decompression. What we do if the patient is resistant to this kind of treatment like medical treatment or radio frequency ablation, then as a neurosurgeon we offer them microvascular decompression. It is a surgery we call, it is MVD. We use both microscope, sometimes we use endoscope, where we open the cranium, we see the brainstem area where the trigeminal nerve get compressed, or it was irritated by the vascular loop. We identify that region and we separate the both nerve from the vessel, and we keep Teflon patch, with that patient gets relief. We used to operate regularly these cases, and generally we get almost 100% good response with this microvascular decompression surgery for trigeminal neuralgia, with very mild side effects. Side effects in the sense it is kind of surgery, so patient may get some kind of pain during the surgery. During that perioperative period, 1 or 2 days, and patient may get some kind of facial abnormality or hearing abnormality that usually subside over a period of 2 to 3 weeks time.